Hello guys, and welcome to my tutorial on Credit Core. A relatively simple co-op on the surface, but with a few tricks to it. Let's get started. Credit Core doesn't really have specific starting hand conditions it relies on. This co-op has a lot of money and an ability that is useful when going for any strat, so you can pick it whenever your other co-op choice just isn't for you. There are certain cards that make this decision definitely easier, but I'll be talking about these in the next segment. There are two main ways of playing Credit Core. Firstly, I want to talk about the ground game strategy with standard tech. This strat is something I like to go for if I draw standard tech in the early game or even have it on my starting hand. It's one of the most insane cards for Credit Core, as this allows you to play standard cities and greeneries with a rebate of 7 mega credits. But don't get fooled and do this in the early game. You rather start by building up a strong mega credit production and maybe some plant prod in the mid game. Then, this strategy really depends on standard tech, so play this card in the mid game. You can just go ham with cities and greeneries from then on. Reserve the best spots with cities and fill in the gaps with greeneries. Other great cards for this strat are obviously efficient plant producers like kelp farming and bushes, but also cards like Immigrant City, Rover Construction, Herbivores and Pets. Another note on this strat: while going for a heavy ground game, you actually benefit from the game ending sooner rather than later. So also try to do some terraforming on the other tracks. The other specific strategy I want to talk about revolves around playing space events to push all terraforming parameters. Credit Core has an edge over other co-ops due to its ability, as almost all of these events have a cost of over 20 mega credits. In the early game, you'll still want to build up an economy consisting of Mega Credit and Titanium Prod. Great cards to pick up for the strategy are obviously Media Group and Optimal Arrow Breaking, but also space discounts like Space Station and Shuttles. Since you can push the Oxygen Drag with only a single space event, towing a comet, you need to find a way to push that track somehow, because similarly to the ground game strat, you want the game to end early, so maybe pick up an Oxygen Bumper or some plant production. Now to some more general tips. Cards get the rebate based on their base cost, so don't hesitate to play any discount cards, such as Earth Catapult, Mass Converter and Earth Office. Don't fall into the trap of only wanting to play cards over 20 mega credits. Great cards are still great cards. Especially in the early game, you probably won't play as many expensive cards, as most of the economy builder cards cost less. Stuff like Acquired Company and Titanium Mine, for example. This basically describes the third way of playing Credit Core. Playing it as a generic co-op with a lot of money and using the ability sporadically when you see fit. This probably is the way Credit Core is played most often, as people tend not to pass standard tech or expensive space events to this co-op. And Credit Core is actually really strong while playing this way. An important thing to establish in many cases, but especially when you're playing a rich co-op like Credit Core, is card draw. You're going to want more and more cards, and due to your strong starting capital and insane rebate ability, you can actually play all of them. So getting card draw is of high importance for you. But even if you don't have enough cards in the late game, Credit Core can efficiently play standard project cities and greeneries, and so you can hopefully end the game fast and win with a strong ground game. Credit Core isn't restricted to go for a specific milestone, but also doesn't have a huge advantage going for any of them. Obviously, the tempo version of Credit Core likes to go for Terraformer, and the standard project version has a realistic chance on Mayor and Gardener. But that amount of starting capital means you can go for any milestone if you have the right cards. As I said in my prelude co-ops tier list, I believe that co-ops with strong starting capital get a smaller boost by preludes percentage-wise. I mean, imagine playing Donation with Credit Core. You start the game with 78 mega credits and probably won't even have enough cards to play with this money. So in most cases, I would focus on card draw or production preludes like Research Network or Mining Operations. The other expansions don't really have a strong impact on the performance of Credit Core, as the percentage of cards with a base cost over 20 varies a little bit, but not by much. Especially Venus Next has a lot of cards over 20. Just two more small things. A. The expansions sadly do not add any new standard projects with a cost over 20. And B. When playing with Elysium, Celebrity is a really good award for Credit Core, obviously. I hope you enjoyed my quick tutorial on Credit Core, and if you did, please leave a like and consider subscribing. See you in the next video.